Saram everyone, a very good morning to all the viewers. How are you all? You all are well? Yes, children. I welcome you in your environmental studies class. And we are studying from which book? We are studying from New Getting Ahead in Social Studies. And can you tell me which chapter we are doing? We are doing chapter number 3. And what is the name of the chapter? Movements of Earth. Yes? We were studying this chapter only. Now, just have a quick recap that in previous video, what topics we have covered in this chapter. Okay, and after that we will complete this chapter. First of all, we studied that about the movements of Earth. How many types of movements Earth has? Earth has two types of movement. First is rotation and second is revolution. How many types of rotation? Two types of rotation. Movements. Rotation and revolution. Now, what is revolution? It is spinning motion of the earth. What is rotation? Spinning motion. Earth is not a stationary thing. Earth always moves. Earth always rotates. And when Earth rotates, it has on an imaginary line, and that imaginary line is called axis. What does it call? It called axis. An imaginary line around which Earth spin is called axis. Due to rotation, what does happen? Due to rotation, day and night happen. Alright? Okay? Due to its spherical shape, only half of the earth receives light from the sun at a particular time, and the half part of the earth has darkness because that part is away from the sun. So, it has darkness and has night. Understood? In previous video till here, we have studied about rotation and day and night. Now, we will study what? The next movement of the earth is revolution. Now, we will study revolution of the earth. In rotation, Earth rotate on its axis, and this is axis, this is an imaginary line. Earth rotate itself. Okay. Rotation. Okay. But in revolution, Earth revolve around sun. Earth and other planets revolve around sun. Okay. And here we are talking about the movement of Earth. So, here we will study the revolution of the Earth. Now, the Earth also moves around the Sun in the fixed path called orbit. You know that Earth is always moving around Sun. And Earth also rotate itself and revolve around the Sun. And the other planets are also orbited. We called it as fixed orbit. Means, suppose this is Sun. This is Sun. Alright. And this is a fixed orbit. मर्करी इज़ द नियरेस्ट प्लैनेट, देन अदर प्लैनेट, देन एंड देन. सो दिस दीज लाइन्स दीज आर कॉल्ड फिक्स्ड ऑर्बिट्स. दीज आर कॉल्ड फिक्स्ड ऑर्बिट मीन्स एवरी प्लैनेट हैज़ इट्स फिक्स्ड पाथ ऑफ रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द सन. इट डजेंट चेंज इट्स ऑर्बिट. ऑल द प्लैनेट्स डजेंट चेंज इट्स path, doesn't change its way. They always revolve or move around the sun in a fixed path, and that fixed path is called orbit. What does it call? Repeat, what does it call? Orbit. Okay, like the same, Earth is always move around the sun in a fixed path. Okay, the third planet is Earth. Okay, Earth always move around the sun in a fixed path, which is called orbit. What does it call? Orbit. All the planets around the sun revolve around it in a constant and continuous path. Always, they never stop themselves. They always revolve. Okay? Now, this movement of the Earth is called the revolution of the Earth. This movement, revolving around or moving around the sun, is called revolution of the Earth. What does it call? Revolution of the Earth. And the orbit is oval in shape. Whenever you have seen the solar system, have you seen the diagram of solar system? Like sun, and this is oval shape. I am not drawing the clean diagram, it is just a rough diagram. This is sun, and these are the orbits of other planets. So the orbit means the fixed path in which they are moving is in a oval shape. What shape? Which shape? Oval shape. It takes Earth about 365 days or 1 year to complete one revolution. Do you know? 365 days. Or sometimes whenever there is a leap year, Earth takes 366 days. 366 days is equal to 1 year, which is equal to one revolution of the Earth. Okay? Mercury is very first and nearest planet to the sun. It takes less time, and when we talk about the last planet, it takes a lot of time. But we are talking about Earth. Earth take 1 year or 365 days to complete one revolution. All right. First of all, Earth always move towards. Sorry, Earth always move around the sun in a fixed path called orbit. Alright? Then this movement is called revolution of the Earth. Then what is the shape of the orbit? The shape of the orbit is oval. And how much time Earth takes to complete one revolution? It takes 365 days or 1 year to complete one revolution. Alright? And we have studied in rotation. Now I am talking about rotation. How much time Earth takes to rotate? It takes. How much time? It takes 1 day to complete one rotation. Okay? And due to rotation, what happened? What causes? Due to rotation, what happened? Day and night happen because of the rotation of the earth. What happened? Day and night happen due to the rotation of the earth. All right. Now we are talking about revolution. Earth take 1 year or 365 days to complete one revolution. So what happened from the movement of the earth? What happened in the revolution of the earth? What happened in this movement? Think about it. I'm going to show you one picture. Yeah. See these four different types of picture. What do you feel seeing all these pictures? What the first thing comes in your mind? What are these pictures related to? Come on, think on it. One more picture. This. A tree can definitely tell you about this, what I am exactly asking from you. Yes. Yes, tree shows the different types of seasons. So due to revolution of earth, seasons happen. Okay. From rotation, day and night, and from revolution of the earth, seasons. There are four different seasons. This picture shows summer, spring, winter, fall or autumn. How many types of seasons are there? There are four types of seasons: summer, winter, autumn, spring. Got it? Now if somebody asks you that what happened from revolution of the earth, what answer you say? You reply, you say that due to revolution of the earth, seasons occur or seasons happen. And what happened because of rotation of earth? Day and night. Now, season. The revolution of the earth causes four seasons. That is summer, autumn, winter, or spring. Second, while revolving around the sun, the earth that is tilted towards the sun gets longer hours of sunlight and has summer. You all know that this is earth and earth is not straight. It is tilted. It is tilted. And what is the actual distance, or you can say it is 23.5 or 23.5 degree tilted. All right, children, this we have studied in our first chapter in globe. Yes, so earth is tilted. Okay, so and here it is sun. So this portion is tilted. So this portion will receive longer hours of sunlight and has summers. Got it, children? and the half tilted away, which is and the half, this portion. This portion. And the half which is tilted away from the sun has lesser hours of sunlight and has winters. And has winters. This portion has summer and this portion has winter. Understood? Now we quickly read these points again so that you can understood it more. First of all, revolution of the earth causes four seasons, that is summer, autumn, winter, spring. Alright, while revolving around the sun, the earth is tilted. The earth is tilted towards the sun. The portion of the earth which is tilted towards the sun gets longer hour of sunlight. Okay, and has summer. You must have seen that in summers the days are long, the days are longer, means the sunlight on earth is for longer hours. Why? Because the earth is tilted, because the earth is tilted, that's why that portion has longer hours of sunlight and that time is summer. If suppose this is which season? Summer season. Yes. So, if you notice that in evening at 7 or 7:30, there is a light. There is light. Not exact sunlight, but there is light. So, that means this is a longer hour, longer day. Longer days because this is summer time. Alright. But in winters, when we compare the day, summer day with the winter day, in winter, there at 5 p.m. or 4:30 p.m. it starts getting dark outside. It starts getting dark outside. So that means that portion is away from the sunlight and have very lesser hours of sunlight and has winter. Alright, understood? Today when you see this video, just notice that in the evening at around 7:15 or 7:30, when you go outside, that it will have light, not sunlight, but it will have light. Okay, same day in winters, if you compare, If in winter you compare, you go out at 7 or you go out at 6 p.m. in the evening, there will be dark outside. After 5 or after 5:30 in winters, it has dark. Why? Because it has lesser hours of sunlight. Okay? Because it has lesser hours of sunlight. Understood? Here you all have understood, right? Now the seasons, earth season, how we come to know that this is summer, how we come to know that now winter will come, now autumn will come, or now spring will come, or how we can judge this. Okay, that in that particular country this time is summer time and that month of that time it has winter, or when spring will come or when autumn will go, like this. This we will come to know from the movements of earth. This is the diagram. After reading the next slides, we will understood this diagram well. So, this is the first point. First, I will read it. When North Pole is tilted towards the sun, obviously, you know that this is Earth and this is the line. This is the axis on which earth moves and it is tilted. Okay. And this becomes north pole and this is south pole, right? This also we have studied in the previous chapters, right? So, when the north pole is tilted, when the north pole is tilted towards the sun, the south pole automatically go far away from the sun. At this time, the northern hemisphere, where is northern hemisphere? It is in the north side and southern hemisphere in the south. When we divide the earth into two equal halves, this portion is the southern hemisphere and this upper portion is a northern hemisphere, right? So, whenever the north pole is tilted, whenever the north pole is tilted towards the sun, the south pole is away from the sun, right? And the northern hemisphere at the same time, the northern hemisphere has summers and the summer and the southern hemisphere has winters. Why northern hemisphere has summers and why southern hemisphere has winters? Because northern hemisphere has summer season because the north pole is tilted towards the sun, right? And why southern hemisphere has winters? Southern hemisphere has winters because at this particular time the south pole is tilted away from the sun. And which month is this? This is June. Alright. Okay. June is the hottest month. Yes. So, whenever the north pole is tilted towards the sun, it has summers in northern hemisphere. And whenever the south pole is away from the sun, the southern hemisphere has winters. Okay, whatever the countries, islands, continents are included in are in southern hemisphere has winter time, and the countries, continents, islands included in northern hemisphere has summer time, right? Now we will see this from the diagram. See, this is the diagram. This is north pole, this is south pole, right? This is southern hemisphere and this is northern hemisphere, right? And this is sun, you all can see. So, and this is the summer time, this is summer time. And this earth is tilted, right? Yes, this is an axis. Okay, so this portion, as this is tilted towards the sun, this north pole is tilted towards the sun, so this area has summer time. This area has summer time, means northern hemisphere has summer. This portion, this south pole is away from the sun. This particular time we are talking about, that south pole is away from the sun. So this particular area has winter time. Understood? Whenever the north pole is tilted towards the sun, means it in simple words, it means it is near the sun. The rays of sunlight are very hot. The days are longer. So, when the days are longer, it has summer time. So, this time is summer here in northern hemisphere. And this time, when the south pole is tilted away from the sun, it has winter. Okay? In northern hemisphere, it has summers. And in southern hemisphere, it has winters. Understood? whenever north pole is tilted towards the sun. Obviously, when it is tilted, south pole is south pole is away from the sun, right? I have made a rough kind of diagram to show it, to show the revolution of the earth. See, this is sun, and we will see the revolution of the earth. Alright, first of all, let me show you, this is Earth. Alright, this is Earth, and you know that it is tilted. This is an axis line. What is this? What is this? This is axis on which Earth rotates, right? Okay, and this is North pole. What it is? North pole. And this portion is called South pole. Okay. And if we divide the earth, we divide it into two halves. Yes. The upper portion called Northern Hemisphere. This lower portion is called Southern Hemisphere. Alright. So, in every four position, first position, second position, third and fourth, in every four position, you notice that about the North Pole and the South Pole. See, this time, this is Earth, this is North Pole, and this is South Pole, right? And when we divide it, the upper portion is Northern Hemisphere and the lower portion is Southern Hemisphere, right? In this picture, I have written this, in this diagram of the Earth. See, when we divide it, hemisphere divides the earth into equal halves. Yes, the portion which comes in North Pole becomes the Northern Hemisphere, and the portion which comes in South Pole, it is Southern Hemisphere. Right. So, here, this North Pole is tilted towards the sun. It is tilted, right? This portion is tilted towards the sun. So it means this northern hemisphere receives sunlight for longer hours. So it has summer time. It has summers here. Right? We have studied this. That when the North Pole is tilted, towards the sun, it is tilted? Yes, when the North Pole is tilted towards the sun, the South Pole is far away. The South Pole is far away from the sun. So, in Southern Hemisphere, it has winter time. The Southern Hemisphere has winter time. Okay? At the same time, the Northern Hemisphere has summers and the Southern Hemisphere has winters. And we consider it as June, the month of June. What do we consider? We consider it as June. In June, the North Pole is tilted. It has summers in Northern Hemisphere. The South Pole is away from the sun. It has winters in Southern Hemisphere. Right? Now, we will talk about this September. North Pole and South Pole. In the month of September, North Pole and South Poles means both the poles are at an equal distance from the sun. North Pole and South Pole are at equal distance, are at an equal distance from the sun. So, in Northern Hemisphere it has autumn. This is Northern Hemisphere. So, in Northern Hemisphere it has? In Northern Hemisphere it has? Autumn. In Northern Hemisphere it has? Autumn. While in the summer, in the Southern Hemisphere it has? Spring. Okay, just read from the screen. In the month of September, Northern Hemisphere has autumn. When the trees shed their leaves, okay? And in Southern Hemisphere it has springs, means new leaves grow. Now we come in the month of December. See, North Pole is far from sunlight, far from sun, and South Pole is near the South Pole is tilted towards the sun. So in Southern Hemisphere it has summer time, okay, and North Pole is away from the sun. So, it has winter in Northern Hemisphere. Understood? Read it. When the South Pole, is tilted towards the sun, and the North Pole is far, from the sun. So, at this time, Northern Hemisphere has winter time. Okay, and Southern Hemisphere has summer season. Okay, now we will come to the month of March. Here, this is North Pole and this is South Pole. And you know that in the month of September and in the month of March, both the poles, the North Pole and the South Pole, are at an equal distance from the sun. Okay? So, in the month of March, this North Pole, or you can say Northern Hemisphere, has spring. Which season? Spring season. While the Southern Hemisphere has autumn. Alright. In the month of September, North Pole or Northern Hemisphere has autumn and Southern Hemisphere has springtime, when leaves start growing again. When we move to the month of March, in Southern Hemisphere, it is autumn time, when trees shed their leaves. And in Northern Hemisphere, it has springtime, when the leaves start growing. When the new leaves are coming. Okay? This is the revolution of the earth. I hope you understood with the diagram. Try to make the diagram also in your notebook. Now, whenever there is summer in India, it is winter in Australia, because India comes in northern hemisphere and Australia is in southern hemisphere. So when it is summer in India, it is winter in Australia, and when it is autumn in India, it is spring in Australia. Okay, understood? Now, thus the revolution of the earth and its tilted axis causes the season. Suppose this is earth and it is tilted. Because of this tilted axis, because of the tilted axis of the earth, it causes the seasons. Understood? Now we quickly recap the whole chapter. Yes, rotate means spin or turn. Earth rotate on its axis, earth spin on its axis. The spinning motion is called rotation. But when we talk about revolution, earth go around, earth moves around, or earth revolve around the sun. Okay, and this movement is called the revolution of the earth. Okay, how much time earth take to rotate? Earth take 24 hours or one day to rotate. And how much time earth take in revolution? Earth take 365 days or 1 year. Okay, what happen because of rotation? What happened because of rotation? Day and night cause. Okay, and what happened because of revolution of the earth? Seasons. How many seasons? 4. Spring, winter, autumn, summer. How many seasons? 4 seasons. Summers, winter, spring, autumn. Okay, have you understood the chapter? Now you have to complete, you have to do the assignment which is given to you after the video in the blue link. You have to click it and complete it. Okay, thank you. Sairam.